ultrasound is very flyable because it's not heavy, it's not taking a lot of power, it's easy to operate. And finally, we have experience flying it. We've flown 8 ultrasound devices over the years before even the space station
8
started. That's correct.
Okay. And no radiation emitted by it, as opposed to?
Absolutely safe, repeatable, transmittable. So the modality just, it sometimes feels it's been created just to fly in space.
It's been created for space. So
exactly.
how does the physics work? I mean, how is ultrasound, so it's sound waves, how is it generated by a traditional system? How are the sound waves work to show you an image? And I know that they could get kind of complicated here and very techie, but just for the lay audience, how does it work and how is this new device that we're working with, the butterfly ultrasound, different than the traditional ultrasounds?
So your traditional ultrasound devices have a piezoelectric crystal that forms the transducer of the ultrasound machine, the ultrasound head, and they typically have what is like 128 elements on average for a lot of the different probes. So they're fairly limited, and they have a very fixed shape. So you have the curved probes, the linear probes, and they're tuned for different frequencies. So they have different depth capabilities. You can either scan something that's shallow or something that's deep. What's unique about this technology that Butterfly has come up with or has developed and commercialized is they are, it's all ultrasound on a chip. So they have micro transducers on a chip. There are 9,000 elements on the face of this.
This is the
probe.
Same chip that would go into what kind of devices today?
It's unique. It's designed specifically to produce and receive
but
ultrasound.
But an equivalent of what would go into your smartphone, your smartwatch?
Essentially.
Okay.
Essentially, yeah.
Very small.
It's a silicon chip. Well, it covers the face of the probe. All the elements are on the probe. But, you know, there are 9,000 elements as opposed to, you know, a couple hundred that might be on a typical probe. So, and they're all individually tunable. So, you know, because of that, they can produce a linear probe that scans at very shallow depths, or a cardiac probe that scans at very deep depths, or you can have a curved probe that for like an abdominal type probe that you would have. They can do all of that with a single probe.
We're looking at devices that can take on at least the medical portion of that function, the standby medical capability portion, into a much smaller size. Something like this that hooks up.
This takes the place of an entire cart of the machine and multiple probes.
Yes, and again, I want to repeat that it's about medical
grade,
acute medical scenarios,
right,
rather than
research.
Comprehensive research applications.
So it works off a smartphone. It's just a simple plug, just like you would a charger.
Yeah, a regular iPhone.
Or Android, they're Android capable.
Android capable, yep.
You plug it in, and it blinks a couple of times. A lot of asks for permission to connect, and it's ready to go. There we go. I'm going to turn on the color mode. There it is.